Morning students, welcome back to Gopi Krishna online classes. Today I am going to continue the topic time and motion. Okay, so in this year we need to learn about measurement. What is mean by measurement? So measurement is defined as comparison of unknown quantity with a known quantity is called as measurement. Okay, so if for example, if you want to measure anything, what you will do with a known quantity, whatever we know, with that we are doing comparison, that is called a measurement. I am repeating the definition of measurement. Measurement is defined as a comparison of known quantity with a known quantity is called as measurement. So, in our daily life, we may cross so many different measurements we are doing, like measurement of length, measurement of some liquids, measurement of some grocery items. For example, if you want to buy sugar, that measurement we need to take, yes or no? If you want to buy any milk or anything, liquids, oil, like that, with measurement only we need to. If you want to measure the cloth, there also we need measurement. Like that, we are depends mostly on measurements. So all these measurements we are considered as the physical quantities. We call as physical quantities. Physical quantities. In these physical quantities, two important things we need to understand here. One is the numerical value and second one is the unit. For example, if you take 1 meter, one is what come here? Numerical value. So this numerical value also important along with this unit. 1 meter, 1 liter, 10 kilometers. Okay, so with this only this will be as a meaningful. Otherwise only 10 means, can you understand anything? Yesterday I told you with example about this. Only kilometer is sufficient? No. Numerical value and its units are very important to know the physical quantity. Okay. So these physical quantities are of two types. Standard quantities are there, non-standard quantities are there. Coming to the standard quantities. Standard quantities will give very accurate measurements to us. That values will not change from person to person, from place to place. Value will be fixed. So we can get very exact, accurate values by using standard measurements. Common standard measurements are SI units. Okay. So in the SI units, meters. Okay. If you want to weight, mass of an object, time of an object. Okay. Sorry, time of an event. We can measure with the help of that SI units. We can get the accurate readings. Along with that, MKS system are also called as SI system of unit. Yesterday we discussed about this SI unit or MKS system of units, CGS units and FPS units. These all of the different system of units we are using in our physical, to measure the physical quantities. These are called as the standard units. Okay, standard measurements. Coming to the non-standard measurements. Non-standard measurements will not give any accurate values. They may change from person to person. Understand me? So here what will happen? For example, if you take a cubit, hand span, foot, inch, like different types of we have these non-standard measurements, but all these non-standard measurements will not give accurate values to us for the measurement of the physical quantities. So we are not using non-standard units to measure that. Mostly we are not using these non-standard units. We depends on these standard units only. Why? Because non-standard units are from person to person, they are going to change from person to person. For example, if you take a tall person with the same age, tall person and one short person, same age persons only get it. Okay, They are not having any crops, but based upon the formation of the shadow. Okay, shadow formation. Okay, in one open area means there should not be any buildings like that. In open area, so if they must run long stick on that. So based upon the formation of the shadow of the stick, they will calculate the time. Let it happen. Okay, so at the same time, the formation of one full moon to new moon. Okay, full moon day to new moon day. The time period they will calculate as 15 days, or otherwise, one full moon day to next full moon day, the time period calculated as 1 month or 29 days. Like that, formation of this revolution of the earth around the sun, it is happening. So, means this.
These all also other units of time.
The second one is that water clock and sand clock. Okay, generally in the ancient period, they are not having any clocks, but based upon these different types of devices, they used to measure the time, measurement of time. They used these devices to measure the time, like sundial. Here the sundial, based upon the formation of the shadow, how the shadow will form. Shadow is a short shadow. In shadow is in our, for example, when you are walking in sun, what will happen? We can observe a shadow, yes or no? So our body is a opaque body, so we can observe that our shadow. So shadow formation is there. So if your shadow is very short, shadow is only in your lens only. So what is the time? Approximately the time? It may be afternoon, yes or no? 12 o'clock like that. Why? Because 12 o'clock like that, what happened? The sun is exactly near the above our head, yes or no? So what happened? There is no formation of shadow there. The shadow will form, but the shadow will be in our, near our lens only. Means we can observe by the formation. If our shadow is very long, means what? Sun is backwards. So what happened? The sun rays will fall, and as our body is opaque body, so what will happen? Our shadow will form very long. So we can expect that we can observe these long shadows maybe in the morning time and evening 4 o'clock, 5, like that. In that time also we can observe the long shadows. Okay, morning we can observe the long shadow, and coming day will increase them. So when sun rises up, what happens? The shadow size will decrease. Shadow size will decrease exactly after the afternoon. The shadow 12 o'clock, like that, the shadow will be near our lens only. Yes or no? So here what happens? From again 12, what happens? Sun will come, moves like this. Okay, so what happened that time? Again, shadow size will going to increase, and up to evening, shadow will be very long again. After this shadow formation, this sundial will work only on daytime. Nighttime, we won't expect any formation of the shadow. Why? Because it depends upon the sun. Okay, so nighttime, this sundial will not work. So one drawback of this sundial is that one only. So it works only at the daytime. It does not work on the night times because there is no sun in night time. Okay, so like that, this sundial, and by using this water clocks also are there, and this sand clock, these three different types of devices are they used in olden period to measure the time. Okay, so measurement of time, why measurement of time is required? After that, different units of measurement you need to learn, and on one ancient period, what type of measure these devices they used to measure the time.